Being angry is a human thing and it is natural. Everyone gets angry at something, but everyone does not get angry at the same thing. That's because of the differences in our value system and our standards and boundaries. Naturally, anger or getting angry is a thing that is human. It's an emotion that is a built-in thing. Just like love is a built-in emotion, same is anger. So as a Christian, do you feel guilty for being angry? Or have you been made to feel guilty for being angry? But you need to note this difference. There's a difference between being angry and having anger. I think we don't place that well. There's nothing wrong with being angry, but there's everything wrong with having anger, since anger is a work of flesh, as stated in Galatians chapter 5. Paul, when he was not converted, went about in anger and zeal, killing Christians, thinking he's doing the Lord a favor. But actually, he was off of the point. God converting him didn't mean he removed the anger from him. So if you are a Christian and you've been saved, God does not remove the aspect of you being angry from you, because he needs to use it for the greater purpose. And the truth is, when God converted Paul, that anger and zeal turned to passion, of which he used to follow Christ and to do his work. By the time you receive Christ into your life, you receive his values, the anger emotion in you will be used to build passion to do the work of the Lord. Number two, being angry keeps you from emotional captivity. Anybody that does not get angry, everything they are cool with, such a person could easily be manipulated, used, and abused. So if such a thing happens in your life, that is where anger was put in you by God, such that it should go against anything that comes as a trait to your value system, to your standard, and to your boundary. So things that get us angry in the natural plane are things that brings displeasure to us. When you are displeased at something, you are displeased at a word that someone says, or at an action or inaction of someone, you start having this boiling and agitation. So it starts that way, and that is where anger starts. That's where you start getting angry. But what we mistake in today is that we feel like until the action comes, which is you felt the boiling, but what we can see as humans is seeing the fight that happens at the end of the day, which is a sin. So anger is a built-in system that God gave to every human being. And this system is a system of alarm that tells you something is trying to breach or presenting itself as a threat to your values, to your standard, and to your boundaries. So if you have a boundary concerning your life and someone tries to invade beyond what you have allowed them, it will displease you. It could be an emotional boundary, it could be a physical boundary concerning your home, it could be a boundary based on anything. And what does the Bible have to say about this? Be angry, but do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your wrath, nor give place to the devil. I would have expected that God would say, do not be angry, because every time you get angry, everybody starts to tell you, don't be angry, please. But the truth is, you have a right to be. Scripture says, be angry. But now, it gives you an admonition. Do not sin. Do not let the anger turn into sin. Because it is sure that there will be offenses. People will offend you, the people you love, and those you do not even know. And the truth is, once they offend you, it makes you displeased. So the agitation, you come up, you start feeling the boiling. So by the time you are displeased, what should you do so that you will not let it become sin? When someone offends you, it has a tendency to get you agitated. You start having short breath. You tremble within you and you feel the boiling. That's the point that it wants to get you to be irrational. It's for you to remain rational and logical. Instead of thinking about what to do to hurt the person back, Scripture is telling you, be angry, but don't catalyze it. Don't be the catalyst. Don't bring a catalyst into the situation that it now turns to wrath and rage. Anger can bring wickedness and it can lead to revenge and all kinds of evil if you allow it. Be angry, but do not let anger control you. You are not supposed to suppress your anger, because it is an inbuilt thing. You are not supposed to suppress yourself not to feel angry at all. That is a wrong teaching if it is given to you at any point. The thing is not to suppress that anger, it is to control it. That is why the Bible says that the fruit of the Spirit, one of it is self-control, such that you know how to manage your temper, because everyone has one. So when it comes to you being offended and being displeased, it's for you to know that it is right for you to feel the way you feel. But acting on it, your reaction and response to it will make it a sin or not. God didn't say don't be angry. But in the lives of believers have gone to the point of being angry and committing sin with it. Because you see a believer say, I will take off this my Christian clothes and deal with you. And when I'm done with you, I'll go put it back. What kind of a believer is that? Such a person presents his or herself as a fool. Being angry starts from what you're feeling, not your reaction, not your response to it. That's where it starts. It begins at the boiling. So when you start feeling yourself being agitated and displeased, trembled on the inside, you are supposed to cool it down. Because anybody that cannot control themselves and their anger will end up being people who can be angry at anything and at nothing, such that the rain could fall, and this is something they can't control, for God's sake, and they will be angry that rain is falling and they wanted to go out. The sun is shining and they'll be angry that the sun is shining and it's being too hot. So now they can even take that anger and pass it down to another person. They'll be offended at anybody that comes across them. It has now turned to sin, because this person now has anger controlling them. They are no more in control. Any little thing displeases them. This anger has now invited its cousins and nephews, which are pride and ego and all those things. And this person feels good feeling that anger, because it's a way for them to feel themselves. And that's where it turns to sin. Number two, be slow to anger. I know there are points in our life that things could happen and someone offends you and you're not so offended to the apex or to the peak. So you are looking for something to catalyze this experience to get you so angry that you do something bad and blame it on your anger. I did it because I was angry. But actually it was intentional. You wanted to get so angry and fill the cup up so that you can act, and then you will blame it on, oh, I was angry. Scripture is telling you, if you want to deal with your anger, be slow to be angry. Don't be hasty to become angry. Understand this, my dear brothers and sisters. You must all be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry. This is what the scripture says. And the way for you to manage or deal with your anger is, when you feel the boiling coming, the Bible says, be quick to listen. Be open to listen to everything someone wants to say to you. Be slow to speak. Don't be so quick to react to what someone does or says to you. Because being quick to speak will catalyze you burning up so quick, that agitation will come to a place that you are no more ready to control it, but you are ready to actually express it. You're ready to show the world who you are. And the scripture tells you, be slow to speak and be slow to get angry, which is telling you, be dull, be inactive to getting angry, to allowing your anger to express itself. The scripture says, good sense makes one slow to anger, and it is his glory to overlook an offense. Well, the Lord's way is always the higher way, and it's difficult kind of to the human feeling, because how do I overlook what you just said to me that displeased me? How do I just let that go? But that, the Bible says, is a thing that a wise person does. And which means the parallel of that is, when you are a fool, you react to everything everyone does to you just to prove yourself. Do not hasten in your spirit to become angry, for anger rests in the bosom of fools. The Bible says anybody that allows anger to settle within them is a fool. That's why the scripture says, do not hasten to become angry. Instead, be slow, be dull to become angry, be inactive, be unreactive to become angry. That's how to deal with it. In Psalm 4 verse 4, it says, meditate on your bed. Sleep and think about it. Think over it. After thinking about it, be still. It's actually a difficult thing, because I'm still speaking to myself too. So as much as everyone gets angry, the Bible is telling you, it is not wrong to feel anger, but it is wrong to allow anger to consume you, to allow anger to detect your actions and your reactions. So in order to deal with this, you need the word of God. David said, thy word have I hid in my heart that I may not sin against you. But when someone is coming at you, is trying to hurt you, trying to offend you, could even be someone you love so much and they offend you, what do you do? God, your word I have hid in my heart that I may not sin against you. It could be a word that it says, do unto others what you wish others to do unto you. Which is, sometimes you learn it in reverse. Someone did something wrong to you, you do not like it. So in anger, because you feel hurt, you would want to naturally revenge. But scripture says, did you like it? You said, no, I didn't like that. Then don't do it. It is the higher way. It's a narrow way. Not everyone goes into this way. I hope this video has spoken to you and you've learned something from it. Do well to subscribe to this channel and give this video a thumbs up. Share this video to others who may need to see it. I am Uwe Makwa, and this is my YouTube channel. Speak to me in the comment section. What are those things that have made you angry before? Or what are the things that someone have done to you that has made you angry to a point that you couldn't control yourself? You actually reacted, because at some points all of us have reacted to anger and we have sinned. This is just to give a perspective of what scripture says about anger, that it is not a sin to feel angry, so that you will not be dehumanized as a person to try to uproot the feeling of anger from you. That's not what the scripture says. But you are not to allow it express itself through you. Because coming to Christ should bring you to a place of transformation, whereby people get you offended and you don't get to react to them based on the offense that you feel. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.